Hello everyone, I'm Chef Umesh, Assistant Professor at Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we are going to learn about Methods of Cooking Part 1. In this chapter, we will learn about different cooking methods, stating the relationship between textures, cooking time and the method of cooking. We'll explain the advantages and disadvantages of the cooking method that we are going to read about. And we'll make ourselves aware about the safe handling rules associated with these cooking methods. To know about different cooking methods, we must know that what is cooking. So it can be explained as food preparation, which require help in combining food ingredients in various ways with delicate flavor, texture, color, to appeal the eyes so that it can be consumed, comes under cooking. Cooking also can be related to the understanding of behavior in specific terms, help in choosing best method of cooking. The method of preparation also plays an important role in meeting the nutritional need of family. Foods like fruit, vegetables and nuts are eaten raw, but most of the food items like meat and other products are cooked to bring about desirable changes in their texture and taste. All these processes of subjecting food to action of heat is termed as cooking. So in our earlier classes, we have read about different types of heat transfer, which contains conduction, convection and radiation. In this cooking method, or in this chapter, we will read about the heat transfer and various cooking methods. For example, dry heat cooking method, which is done with the help of hot air or hot fat. Moist heat cooking method, which is done with the help of water or steam. And the combination of both of these methods, which are mentioned above, that is dry heat and moist heat cooking methods. Starting from dry heat cooking method, it can be explained as it is a technique of cooking without using moisture. Now there comes a query or question in our mind that why do we count our fat frying or fat cooking under this cooking method? And that the reason behind that is it doesn't contain any moisture or water. That is the reason we count it as dry heat cooking method. In dry heat cooking method, we can number these broiling, grilling, roasting, baking, sauteing, pan frying and deep frying. Typically this method contains or involves high heat with the temperature ranging from 300 degree Fahrenheit to above that. In this cooking method, the heat transfer takes place through the hot metal of the pan, which can be related to the conduction mode of heat transfer. We must note that browning of food, including the process by which meat is browned, is called, which is also known as Maillard reaction. That browning can only be achieved through dry heat cooking. If we boil it or cook it with the help of moist heat, we might not be able to achieve that browning on the surface of the ingredient. Under broiling, it can be done with the heat source coming from the above or with the heat source coming from the below. The method of cooking known as broiling uses radiant heat from an overhead source to cook the food. One of the con or disadvantages of this cooking can be the loss of heat due to the open surrounding. So the food is kept close to heat source. That is the reason food is cooked quickly from outside. But we need to take care that it is cooked thoroughly from inside too. This method is good for cooking poultry, fish or tender cuts of meat. While broiling from the heat source from above, we will not get any grill marks. However, we would get the gratination marks or a outer crust. When using heat source from below, it will give us grill marks. As we see in a barbecue or in a hot plate, we usually get the outer covering or outer crust so easily with the marking on our meat product or our food product. There are certain advantages of grilling and barbecuing, which are: grilling is a quick and easy method of cooking. While grilling, there is a little loss of nutrients because our food is cooked from outside first and it is sealed. Less fat is used in grilling or barbecuing, then grilled food are tasty and easy to digest. The disadvantages are numbered or counted as: grilled food cannot be successfully reheated because they are already cooked from outside. If we reheat them, it might happen that the outer layer would burn out. Then they need to be served straight away just after the cooking them, and only tender cuts of meat can be used. Grilling and barbecuing also require some precautionary methods while using it, which are: do not leave food unattended while cooking. Keep work area clean and floors free from split grease. The second point should be considered or should be taken care in every type of cooking. Then exercise great care when adjusting grill bars or salamander racks. Never touch any hot item with the bare hands. That is the reason it is always mentioned that feel before you pick up anything, because it might be hot and it would burn your hand. Next slide shows roasting and baking method of cooking, or roasting and baking method of dry heat cooking. So roasting can be explained as cooking food like meat or poultry with some fat in a hot oven between the temperature of 200 to 240 degrees centigrade. However, baking is done at 120 degree to 240 degrees centigrade. Baking method of cooking is usually used for preparing cakes, pies, bread, etc. This baking method takes longer duration to cook the food. However, roasting can be done faster than baking if compared. Advantages of roasting and baking are that they barely use any fire, so there is no fire risk, or very few incidents are reported, or very minimal fire risk is there. Meat juices from meat can be used for gravy, which enhances the flavor and which can be collected in the roasting tray or baking tray. This gives a variety to menu. Then there are disadvantages that are: constant attention is required. As you mentioned in our barbecuing and grilling, it is also required to constantly attend our food to check whether it is cooked or not. Then losses of nutrients like amino acids is also and are counted disadvantages of roasting and baking. Safety measures that we need to count on or need to take care of are: correct degree of cooking of meats must be accurately measured to protect from parasitic worms and pathogenic bacteria. Care should be taken when handling hot oven trays to prevent spillage of hot fat. Then safe practices should be observed in operational procedure, clothing and footwear. Here this slide shows us difference between or different method of cooking with the help of fat. So it might be sauteing and pan frying, which can be explained as: sauteing is a cooking method which involves cooking small or thin pieces of food in a little or very hot oil. The frying pan is shaken constantly to stop the food from burning. Pan frying is similar to sauteing, but it requires less shaking of food because bigger joints are usually cooked, or bigger pieces of ingredients are usually cooked in this method of cooking. However, due to the bigger pieces, it requires more fat. This diagram or figure shows how sauteing works. So in this method, the pan is first made very hot, then a fat medium is added to it so that it would help our ingredient to get browned. Then we should always take care not to overcrowd our pan while sauteing or pan frying. Then always keep tossing your food while sauteing or using sauteing method of cooking so that it won't get burned. In our last slide, we'll learn about deep frying method of cooking. while using fat or any other fat medium. Deep frying can be explained as frying pieces of food in a deep pot or fryer with plenty of hot oil or fat. With this slide, we will end our today's topic. For any other query, you may reach out to me at umesh.chugran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you so much.